When the HBO comedy Silicon Valley poked fun at a fictional company modeled on Google...
These programmers, there's always a tall, skinny white guy,
short, skinny Asian guy, fat guy with a ponytail, some guy with crazy facial hair.
Google executive Brian Welly saw an opportunity.
So this is the world's view of Silicon Valley, and there is some truth to it.
Welly conducts what's called unconscious bias training for tens of thousands of Google employees. It's a key component of the company's diversity strategy.
So what we want to do is understand, what role do we play in making this happen?
Ever since the tech giant publicized its gender and ethnic makeup in 2014, it's been under pressure to add more women and minorities to its workforce. Nancy Lee is vice president of Google's people operations.
We were just trying to shine a light on what was going on in our own company and in this sector because we really did want to catalyze a conversation and hold ourselves accountable, because once we exposed it, we can't just go silent.
But after spending almost 2 years and $265 million on the effort, Google's workforce looks virtually the same, 70% men and 60% white. 31% of employees are Asian, but only 3% are Latino, and only 2% are black. For a company with nearly 60,000 employees, change will probably be subtle and slow.
There's no silver bullet here. We're not going to see this massive shift. Frankly, it would probably look unnatural for that to happen.
One small change, women in senior management positions, 22%, up 1% since 2014.
And that is a function in part of the fact that the pipeline itself, the pool of talent we're drawing from at each level, is getting increasingly male.
One way to address the pipeline problem is to challenge stereotypes of engineers, and Google has turned to Hollywood for help. Mariana is a Latina teenage computer programmer on the TV drama The Fosters. And there's Loretta, the smart older sister, on the animated Disney Junior show, Miles of Tomorrowland.
My program can detect if anyone else out there is coding right now.
Google has been advising Disney ABC to develop engineering characters that girls can relate to.
We found that, in fact, the perception of what it is to be a computer scientist is a really important factor.
Erica Baker overcame stereotypes to become a software engineer and worked at Google for 9 years, but felt she didn't fit in.
That was really interesting when I got to Google, that people thought I was only there because of affirmative action. It's like, nope, I'm actually pretty good at my job.
Baker felt antagonized by messages posted to Google's internal communication system, like,
diversity isn't important. People would say that and more.
So she left the company last May.
I decided that I didn't want to be a part of it anymore. I wanted to go to a place where I didn't have to deal with people questioning my abilities and questioning whether or not I should be there because of my skin color.
Google wouldn't comment on her complaint. The company says it does not comment on specific employees. But Google does say it's trying to create a more inclusive culture, producing videos.
What would the world look like if everybody were aware of the stereotypes that they have?
And offering bias-busting workshops like this one, where employees role-play.
I'm sorry, do you know when they're going to be restocking the Diet Coke in the fridge?
You know, I don't, but I was wondering the same thing. And
this scenario actually happened to her.
I was in a different office where they have like a barista bar, and someone was like, oh, can you make me like a cappuccino or something like that?
Jason Bouverel, who runs some of these workshops, hopes they will encourage underrepresented engineers to stay with the company.
What I would like to see over time occur here at Google is to see the attrition rate of women minorities in engineering roles decrease over time.
Nancy Lee says Google is in it for the long haul.
To see something significant where we're actually hitting the market supply, you know, of 10% or something like that of Hispanic and black Googlers, that's going to take several years.